Hi everybody, welcome back to TerraFirmaCraft with me, Sid, and this is just a very quick intro, and you can obviously hear the chickens. There's quite a few chickens. Let's have a look how many chickens we actually have. We've got a lot of chickens. Now, if you ignore the clucking sound, and I don't know whether you can hear this on your end, but from my end this is really obnoxious. Can you hear that little tippy 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 sound? It's really, really faint, just on the edge of hearing, probably almost not even there for you, but for me it is just there. It is obnoxious. It is the sound of the chicken's little feet tippy tapping. Okay. Keep that in mind, I'll be back in a... Alright, and we're back. And, listen. You can't hear, well, I can't hear the tippy-tapping of little chicken feet. I'm guessing, but you go, well, I know you can't hear it, because I can't hear it. But, yeah. I've just installed a little utility mod. It's by a fella called Anthony Sheets. It's available on the Curse site. It's got the most adorably cute name in the world. It is called Chicken Mittens. And the only thing it does is get rid of the tippy-tappy sound of chicken feet. But it's well worth it. Oh, yeah. Anyway, yeah, check it out. Chicken Mittens by Anthony Sheet. If you get fed up at tippy taps, then this is the one for you. Right, let me make myself a few more. I did forget that chicken made there. I'm going to get myself a whole load of bowls made, because now they come back to you most of the time. They're actually probably easier than having to worry about making the grain based food all the time. So what's the plans for today? Well, I am going to start off down by the road making myself a little bit more road. You're a wrought iron hoe. I should have a oh, there you are, my stone hoe, all necessary. We're going to want gravel. Any old andesite we've got, I probably won't need dirt, we'll take that. I'm not going to use those because they don't really, in my mind, fit. I might actually throw in the odd bit of, yeah, that's a good idea. Now we're getting really rough on this. We'll throw in the odd bit of old things. I need to find somewhere for those to live as well at some point. Bit of more sand, more gravel. Anything else interesting there? Nope. Oh, yes, cobble. Can't forget a bit of cobble. Got to have cobble to make it, give it that, you know, that legitimacy that it needs. We could actually throw a few of those in as well. Not too many. But, you know, a few. That's andesite. A bit more cobble there. Anything else? I don't think so. I think we've probably now got pretty much everything we need. All right, let us go find my os, and we'll head back down and continue on the road. Because I've got a plan for this road, thanks to you guys. It appears that Reddit isn't the only forum where bridges are a thing. No, YouTube goes bridge mad as well. While we've been away, we've had baby pigs, and they are adorable. Some of them have spawned in the wrong side. But we've got a lot of them. And, yeah, give me a rope. Rope. Oh, dear. Come on. I think we've got more baby cows somewhere as well, didn't we? Yeah, this is brand new. That's a fresh one. Yeah, these are fresh. baby cows. Okay. Come on. Horse which will not be named. Forward ho. Yeah, it's a bit of a shame that we can't name this guy. It's all apparently to do with the level of familiarisation you have with him. You can't name them until you've got a full golden heart. But you can't get a full golden heart on an animal until you've actually bred it and raised its offspring, or several generations of its offspring. So I've been doing a little bit of work, and we're coming around this way. And the idea is I'm going to come around here. We're going to not so much bridge this, because there's a little bit of tiny little bit of a ravine there, but it's not a proper ravine. It's not a deep one. We're going to come around over there, and hey, if we can do this, we're going to come to about this point, and we are going to bridge over this lake to that little promontory over there. Because the problem with doing a ravine, or probably doing a good bridge on a ravine, you know, is it's only a few wide. Zombie really does want a little piece of me, doesn't he? So yeah, I think we need to find somewhere a bit more challenging for the bridging thereof. Now, what I'm going to do is, we'll get off and do this. I think. Oh, that's not a pick. Pick. Where's my pick? There. And you, come on, in. No, in. In. Thank you. And then we'll disengage rope and. The world is good and happy. You should be trapped in that. I don't think you can get out. That's what I sincerely hope anyway. So yes, I've done a little bit of digging, but not actually done any work down there. We'll pop you in and we'll take you. So I'm going to take this across and down, and then we'll see where we go from there. And then I need to start clearing some more logs. Got my bed, got some food, got some water, so we're good for a few days worth of a few Minecraft days worth of doing things. So yeah, I'll continue on with this. All right, we're just back for a few supplies actually right now. I ran out of building mats, and so I thought while we're here, because I brought a whole load of wood back with me, if I can find a full stack of something, we can get this fire. Oh, we can't. The fire pit's almost ready, but I haven't got any torches. We can almost get this fire pit. Actually, we can get this fire pit ready, can't we? I've got a flint and steel. Yeah, because I'm curious to know if I'm going to set this lot on fire or not. So, yeah, as I say, I've been busy, got a little bit further around, and just run out of the crappy building materials. Hey. Okay, need to take you back out. Get you, go, and... That's awkward, isn't it? Damn it. Need to make some torches then, don't I? I also need some sticks. Oh well, we'll do that later. Or should I do it now? Let me just grab some sticks, get some torches done. If I can find some of the basics things, like, say, sticks. I'm actually running really low on. I'm going to have to scythe some trees at some point. But yeah, where are we now? We've got... Oops, hang on. We have got... I've lost myself. I'm here. Come all the way around there, all the way around there. We're kind of cutting across country here down to there. And this is the bit I'm just filling in to get us down to this point. And that's the point we'll bridge across. And then from there, we can continue on down, probably around this bit of mountainous area here, and past the hematite that I think we may have found, down to the logging camp, which obviously is quite a way from the trees now. But yeah, let me get some food sorted out, because I'm a bit low on that as well. And I will be back with you. All right, here's where we find out whether we set fire to the trees or not. I don't think it will. but we've got pretty much everything we need now, so we can leave that one running. As I say, I have my gut feeling is this is not going to set fire to the place. My gut feelings have, however, been wrong on occasion. So, yes, we'll leave those. I've got I've got a stack in TFC terms of thing. My ore should still be here. Bunk, thank you. Minecraft and rope physics. Or paintings, for that matter. Let's not be totally ropeist here. Paintings are rubbish, as are item frames, for exactly the same reasons. But yeah, so head back, and I may move my... might just move the bed a little bit closer while we're heading back this way, because thing is, you put down your stuff, you go and start like piling wood up and things. You mean? And then you get further away, so you're having to walk further back. I don't mind having to walk further back for this fella at all. That's not a problem, because we're just come on. Did we? Oh God! Right, there's one. Oh, there we go. Got all three back. God, right. Yuli, stay there. So we've still got quite a bit of timber there. But I don't think we're going to have much more. So coming through here, I've left these mushrooms because they've not sprung off. So why take them up? Also realised I've got a bit of conglomerate gravel, which adds an interesting effect there. That's andesite. That probably needs to be changed up. So we're to here now, and we're coming round this corner to join up with this bit of road here. That's the aim. And it's pretty much of a lot of the same. We're going to throw some of these, odd few of these. I had to make a few more in because I ran out of these completely. We're going to have dirt and stuff, and you know, it is just a rough old road. Right, that's enough of those. We'll stick I didn't get much of that, so we'll take those. And it's not like we can't get more andesite very easily. And then we'll stick a little bit more gravel in. The rest will be dirt, and some of that will be hoed. Oops. And then it's down on the last leg, really. Which should be interesting. You can go, then we're coming down here. Like so. Yep. It's all starting to come together now. And it is largely random placement, or semi-random placement of whatever you're placing. I did bring some more. God, I thought, Christ, did I not bring dirt with me? Now, for a lot of these, I'm not actually bothering digging out. I'm just digging out the bits that are going to be something other than dirt. So for down here, I can dig out the bits that are going to be something other. Did I just hear the arr of a burning zombie? Possibly. Oh, it's getting on to night time, so we'd better sleep anyway. So we'll pop our bed here for now. Okay. So yeah, we've got that last leg down there, and then we're into working out what we're going to do for a bridge, which I've got a few ideas. I will need some more materials, of course, but since when's that stopped me? So yeah, come on, just let me sleep. See you. Yeah, all right. So we're over here. We've got as far as this. Now what I want to do is I'm going to use a mixture of the local woods to go from, it's going to be four wide, the bridge bed, sorry, it's going to be four wide plus on the outsides, and we're going to make the bridge bed out of this willow. The roof is probably going to be willow too. And when I say roof, you probably worked out, if you haven't, then I'm going to go for one of those covered bridges, I think. I think they're called covered bridges. The these are the bridges that you see in, I don't know, I suppose, for want of a better word, cliched horror movies. Scooby-Doo would be another one where you'll see them. Anyone where you want some kind of little rustic style environment. And sometimes the white, I think the red is quite a common colour. I obviously haven't got a huge money. I can always go and get a cockatoo from the there. That will give us some red walls. I might do that, actually. Right, so we're here. We just need to come round you. And that's fine because that's the other side of this. And then we need to take out this tree here for starters. Come on, out you come. Thank you. And probably, well, we will need to take out this tree when we get to it. Almost certainly that willow tree. Or willow trees might be actually a more suitable a description. And we'll have a couple of supports in the middle. And yeah, we'll get on with, you know, we're going to make a bridge. That's what we're going to do. We're making a bridge, and you know, it's going to be all wonderful and bridge-like. But in the first instance, it's going to be a big layer of these planks all the way across both sides. And yeah, it's just not going to get any more. I mean, these actually, I don't really need to do those. Those are almost secondary. But yeah, I think definitely we'll have some of that red. Oh, is it getting on? It's getting on sleeping time. My God, where does the time go? Right, let's eat, sleep, and be merry. So yeah, I'm going to get the basic structure done, and I'll be back in a bit. And back again for more supplies. So yeah, it's mind you, without this horse, this would be really seriously difficult to build. But then, without this horse, we wouldn't be building this. So yeah, it's kind of swings. It's all your fault, horse. Right, so where are we? Well, we've got the bridge bed across. That's it. And we need to get you off, pick you up, and I've been and grabbed some bits and pieces. I do, in an ideal world, need a whole bit of chunk of stone as well. So I'm just wondering where the best place to mine that from might be. I don't want to do it right next to the road. And I don't want to do it there because that looks bloody dangerous. do we need it? Let me just have a peek, shall we? So this is currently four wide. So it's two for the thing. I'm going to have another two, and then we're going to have another two to get the full width. It's going to be much wider than it needs to be. And if we are looking at that, this one and this one are the middle. This one and this one in the middle. Yeah, that doesn't need to be there, does it? No, that does not need to. Hang on. Don't want to break that. Okay. So what I was thinking, and we want to take you out. You'll not be visible. Doesn't matter. We're going to have, this is the way the bridge bed is going to be, and then there's that one. There's like a little shape over there. It's actually here. This is where the actual bridge bed is going to be, or the support pillar, I should say. And it's going to have that kind of going on there, and then maybe, just maybe, we can go with the middle. So we're going to go 1, 2, 3, and let me just check, that's 3, 4. Yep, to there. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. So that is the base. And then we've got brought these along, which are going to be our main supports. Maybe going like this and like this on either side. And then I've got the chisel, of course, because we wouldn't be doing TerraFirmaCraft if we weren't playing with chisels, would we now? Of course not. Let me change the mode to the stair, I think. Maybe like that. And similarly, like that. Now, I was thinking here, maybe to go in one. And same again, and we can probably do the same here. Yeah, this makes sense. This works. Let me chip you out. And we'll chip you out. Wherever you went. Waste not, want not, especially not when the bricks and stuff, because they cost a lot to make. So, well, that gives us a fairly massive support pillar. I'm just wondering whether it needs a little bit more dressing up with something. Maybe something. No, that's going to be too much, isn't it, if we do that? No, I think we kind of leave that where we're at with that one. And then we duplicate over on the other side. Yeah, we'll go with that for the time being. It's a start. Now, I suppose we could, if we really wanted to, we could, I don't know whether I can going to be able to see to do this from here, but how's about if I do something like that? Just gives it a, I don't know, a, yeah, actually, no, I do like that. That works. What do we do there? We took out that one. Just gives it a little bit of three-dimensionality to it. Right, I'm going to repeat that over the other side. I'm going to need to get some more of this smooth andesite, which is just as well. I happen to have a chisel on me. And, be back in a little while. Well, I seem to have managed to duplicate everything there. It's all right, easy fixed. We've copied my files by accident. So I ran out of acacia, so I've been out to get some more, in fact, for the logging camp. I also managed to pick up some raspberry bushes, which I found by the simple expedient of running the horse into one. Not the best way to find raspberry bushes, but obviously the horse has got bucket loads of hit points. So what we've currently got going on at the moment is I've done acacia down the edge as a thingy, as a hoofer, that's the word, hoofer doofer. Now, okay, I just wondered whether there was any way at all that we could utilize this. Don't like it. But we may be able to use it up on the top level, so I'm not going to write it off immediately. This is fairly bland. Now, there's a reason why I'm going with this particular double thick layer. And that reason is simply, I want to have, I'll probably do use some more green down here, but I want to have this going all the way along, and then we'll have this level here is actually the ground level. And yeah, that's basically it. Let me just get another one of these sliced up. Trying to think what I'm at now. Probably getting fairly close to end of this episode as well. We're not going to finish this bridge. This episode is, it's too big a project, I think, to do in one go. But what we will have then is at this end, we will have, it will go 1, 2, 3. All right. Obviously, we need to be 3 high. 2, 3. for the horse to go through, maybe even four high, and then we'll take the roof over at this point. That's the plan. And then we will do down here. We'll probably have the green floor. I'm not sure about that green floor, you know. I really am not sure about that at all. You'll have to let me know what you think about that one. I mean, we have alternatives. I think, well, not here, but we do have alternatives. There's pine and maple. Quite a few varied alternatives like that. And I'm going to use some of this, some of that, a little bit of that, some of that, and some of that down the middle. And the road will just continue on. Be a lot more man-made blocks, I think, in this section. And we'll just continue the road on through here to the other side, and then obviously continue it on as we go. And that is essentially the plan. Only got a couple of bits of that, haven't I? So let's not put it all down. So that's what I want to do within there. I better eat before I put my head down in the ground. There we go. Running a bit low on food here as well, so definitely getting close to the close of play on this particular episode. And then, as I say, we've got a roof to put on it and all sorts of fun things. Okay. Let's continue on with this vein of thought. So you've got your this kind of thing going on. It's just really, again, keeping this random roadbed theme going through the through it, and maybe a odd one of those as well. Have I got any? Did I put sand? I didn't. It doesn't matter. So the question is, what wood to use there? I don't want to use acacia. I think acacia will be way, way too much. Way too much, in fact. Let me just head over. I know I could get the horse; it'd be quicker. But yeah, we've got some of the other woods over here, so we can go and grab a few of those and see what we think. Do do do, and then I really ought to do something about that as well. That's gonna bug me if I leave that there. Do do do. Oh, my axe broke, so I'm finally on my new axe now, which is nice. Been waiting for that thing to break for what seems like ages. Okay, what we got here? We have got maple, and we got pine and maple. And another stack of maple. Let's just put those and take that, and we'll take that. I think possibly the pine might be a little bit too pale, and the maple might be a little bit too orange. Yeah, the endless curse of the Minecraft builder, which block to use. Oh, and there we go, there's another bowl down. There's clay field over there, so I need to dig some of that and take it back with me so I can make a whole load of bowls when we come to do this. But let us have a look at you. So 32 maple and 32 pine. Let us see what we think. The pine might be the better one, actually. Let's go. Just bear with me. All right, sorry about that. Wife just wanted to know when I was picking the car up. So these are the two options. I actually think this is probably the better. It kind of merges better in with that colour there. The maple than that. I mean, do let me know what you think. I mean, it's not a big job to change it, but I do think that there is the winner. Yeah, I think that definitely maple. Let me know if you disagree. but we got lots to play with anyway. So, yeah, anyway, we're getting there steadily. We've got the old bridge. We've got a bridge bed. We've got nice little massive supports going on there. And we're starting to get a feel for what this thing's going to look like once it's finished. So I think on that note, we're going to call it an episode. And until next time, thanks for watching, guys. And I will see you soon. Bye for now.